Pembroke's Players Championship Finals, coming to you live on ITV Sport from Butlins, Minehead! I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome the millions of viewers joining us around the world. It's time now to meet the players, the Jammy Dodger, James Wilson. And ladies and gentlemen, it's never too late to get this party started. Snakebite, Peter
in the commentary box for the last couple of matches of the night, Alan Warren a little and John Rawling.
Thank you very much, Jackie. Well, Peter Wright, a big favourite to win this one. And you know, when you look back over their meetings, they played each other six times. Six times Peter Wright has been the winner, and he's in form. He was in the final of the Grand Slam, and he's loving the adulation that he's getting from the Minehead crowd. Happy boy today.
He certainly is. Well, there's no bungalow zippy, but Mr. Rainbow is looking as colourful as ever.
James Wilson, the younger man, 47 actually, not 37, comes from Huddersfield and, as you see, ranked number 61 in the qualifications here for this, this tournament. But if he were to win, it would be a major upset, huge upset.
Yes, it'll certainly be an upset. And from James's point of view, he hasn't had the best of seasons, had a couple of issues that he's trying to sort out. This is a big task against Peter Wright, in very good form, as we know. Certainly one of the most popular players on our circuit.
Was getting to the final of the Grand Slam.
First leg is Peter to throw first.
In the final of the Champions League of Darts as well. So a couple of tournaments there, which led to him trousering a total of 115 grand, which isn't bad.
Not too shabby.
Change of darts again there.
What a hundred and eight!
Just going to say, let's see how they go. Well, there's your answer straight away. Maximum with the first three.
85.
Oh, some serious amount of metal in those, isn't they?
100.
Oh, he must have a dart case like a suitcase. Oh, the times of changes, and they look pretty heavy, don't they?
98.
I didn't, well, it's difficult to do research on what Peter Wright's darts are and how much they weigh, because they kind of change every other match, don't they?
If one of those bounces out the board, you'll see everybody duck on stage.
100.
That is some hair design that he's got this evening.
Yes, I'm sure Joe has worked hard on that all day to get that ready for the TV stage.
121.
Winner of this play is Chris Dobie in the next round, who accounted for Christo Reyes in his match. So Wright, 121, great first dart.
They go for 25 in the second out there, no. Doesn't have to go for the ball, that's why I was pondering whether he was going to go for the 25, because he didn't need to go for the 11 if he's not going to go for the ball, if you see my point.
I see entirely.
Thank you, John. I'm glad you're following.
I'm listening. Might be getting late, but I'm still paying attention.
85.
Let's get it on!
32.
Double 16 for the opening leg.
Peter
an important dart and the shake of the head. He's not happy that he made heavy weather of it in the end. But in the crucial dart went, and he's got his nose in front.
Yes, a nice tidy 15 dart leg there, so he's only allowing his opponent 4 visits to the board. Started the first leg with a maximum. Started the second one. Exactly the same.
He's looking fairly happy with those darts at the moment, as well he might.
140.
But I tell you what, Alan, I mean, the idea's three in a bed. That's what he's looking for. And he'll be looking to do it again here. But they've got such width in the shaft.
Well, I suppose if, just for instance, you're going for the 1-3-2 finish and you hit the ball with the first one, it was right in the middle, you would find that very hard to get the second one in. That's his choice, but James Wilson's having a pretty good scoring leg of his own here. 98 after 9.
Yeah, he's averaging 111, Peter Wright, so he's not struggling too much, is he? Incidentally, James Wilson, he's averaging 114 at this point, but of course he's not got down to a double as yet.
121.
He's got the opportunity now, 98.
He'll
be wary that Peter Wright is on a two-darter. So in his mind, he'll be thinking he's got to take this. Treble 18 for double 12. So he can't do it now. So no doubt at the double on that visit.
Now this is for a break of throw. Treble 20, he would hope for. Oh dear, 97, so treble 19 for tops. Yes, great cover shot for the break of throw, and he's got it.
Oh, wonderful dart there, especially with the first one going in the treble one. Fortunately for him, it was in the treble and not the single, otherwise he wouldn't have been on the finish, but it was. Look at the dart there, look at the angle. Good start from both players, it has to be said. James Wilson yet to have a dart at the double, despite averaging over 100.
45.
Both players start with 45 as we're pulling them up there, John.
Yeah. One meeting this year came in a Pro Tour event in Barnsley, and Peter Wright won that one 6-3.
100.
Yeah, so one thing about Peter Wright, he tends to play a lot of the Players' Championship events to keep his game on the top level.
Oh, 140.
Jammy Dodger. He had a spell where he went away from that nickname, but he's gone back to it.
Yes, I'm not surprised. A lethal biscuit.
76.
Lethal biscuit didn't just sound right, did it?
No.
And he's such a gentle fellow, you know, the idea of him being lethal, it didn't quite stack up.
Well, at the end of the day, you try some things. If they work, 40. You keep doing them. If they don't, you stop doing them. Unlike Peter Wright with his darts.
Were you always an ice man, or did you have another one at 10 stage?
Always that one from the start. I've been called a few more things.
100.
Leave that one there.
Third maximum, still averaging 108, Peter Wright.
Yes, an on throw in this one, so he's making it hard for
80.
James Wilson. If you look 100. At the legs he's had, you know, that's why James Wilson, despite averaging still high, hasn't had a dart at the double yet.
Unlucky there, James, on the bounce out of the treble bed. double 10 now for 3-0.
80.
He will return. Nothing James Wilson can do.
100.
Believe himself something better. 20.
Two out of five he's had on his doubles. Oh, double five. Big adjustments.
15.
Oh,
long way off there.
96.
Do some damage to the average.
Well, under 100 for the first time. Double 18 for his first leg in the match. Should be a decent marker.
Yes, and
in we go.
James Wilson.
That's all right. That's a massive opportunity there. All of a sudden, James Wilson breaks a throw. He's throwing first here to get back level. Didn't look likely 5 minutes ago.
No, absolutely not. Just goes to show you get a little bit sticky on the doubles. And things can change very quickly.
Back in the treble.
81.
They are some proper bombs then, aren't they? Almost launching with a catapult.
If he'll stay with them for the whole tournament, might be a big ask.
I think we've all got past them kind of questions nowadays. They're certainly hitting the treble well. Just the elusive double in that last leg has been the only mistake really he's made. There we go, the snake bite glasses.
Available from all good shops.
You never know, you might find
a pair in your stocking on the morning when Santa's been.
I look forward to that, thank you, Alan.
96. PG require 155.
So, treble 20 and then down on the 19s. Can't be done now, just checking. Thought it was in, but it's not. So James Wilson tops to square up the match.
Yes, and, you know, he was 2-0 down, hadn't really done a lot wrong. Could have gone 3-0 down, managed to steal the leg, despite not playing badly himself, you know, he's still averaging 100. This for 2-2.
Yeah, the mark of the first one, and the match level again. First game. Break at the end of this leg, and we're back on throw.
Yeah, it's important for Peter Wright to take this leg on throw going into the break after leading 2-0. Otherwise, he will be thinking about that leg that went away. That really would have put the kibosh on Wilson.
What do you think has been the performance of the day so far?
Well, you've got to go for young Luke, haven't you? You know, one of his debut on the big stage against one of the top players in the world, reigning champion. And held himself together well.
And didn't he speak well afterwards?
Yeah, he's a nice kid.
Made himself a lot of friends.
92.
It just shows you that, you know, if you can keep your composure on stage, we talk about experience, but it's about dealing with the situation that he was in, and he dealt with it pretty well.
Wright looks as though he's going to go to this interval ahead.
83.
Provided he can find a double. He's only had 2 out of 8 now.
Yes, he missed a lot of darts in leg three, didn't he?
140. PG require 147.
Treble 20. Great dart. Treble 17 would leave him on double 18. Oh, perfect. Oh, what a way to clinch that first session. A 147 checkout. Terrific stuff from Peter Wright. And at the interval, with an average of 106 against 99 for James Wilson, he leads 3-2. Action here in Minehead, and Rob Cross is through into the next round with that 6-2 victory over Ron Muhlenkamp. Cross will play in the next round. Jamie Hughes, Yossa going through, and that match taking place tomorrow, but he'll be reasonably pleased with that. Back here on the main stage, underneath the big top here at Butlins, the 5,000-seater arena, Peter Wright is 3-2 ahead.
Yes, marvellous 147. Not wonderful in snooker, the 147, but certainly wonderful for Wright. He's going at that break. 3-2 ahead.
Game.
He missed the opportunity in leg three to go 3-0 ahead. Back come James Wilson. They've levelled it 2-2. Both players are still scoring pretty well. All of a sudden, a break can change that. Who has got the composure early on in this second session?
Chris Dobie awaits in the next round for the winner of this game.
60.
He's not happy with the first two visits there. He's given the throw back already to Peter Wright, who is jumping on it.
Happily seizing the initiative, isn't he? He'd love to find another treble. Wright does.
140.
He's in control now.
I'd love to see the flight path of those darts when they leave the hand. And Sid used to talk about the wibble and how the dart sort of went down before it went up.
Oh,
they just seemed to like they could go straight.
There'd not be a lot of wibbling and wobbling there, would there? I think they'd go in pretty much like bullets.
Yeah. Missiles. Well, there's one thing when Peter Wright retires, he can open his own dart shop.
Oh, 99. PG Rigoire, 121.
Sometimes uses the bull. Treble 20 would leave double 18 now. For 121.
Brilliant.
He's throwing well, Alan. Really is, averaging 109 now, and that's the break of throw he wanted.
Yeah, just that one mistake, as we've mentioned a couple of times in leg three, but the last two legs, 147 finish, 1-2-1.
Could wind up being the highest average of this first round. Still got Nathan Aspinall and Raymond van Barneveld to come.
Well, that should be a tasty encounter.
Not a bad way to finish.
Yeah?
Not a bad way to end the evening, is it? I don't see too many people leaving the arena either.
No, they're all looking forward
to that one. Could be the last time we see Raymond van Barneveld playing competitively on an ITV screen.
Yeah, possibly. He's got a tough draw against Nathan, who's one of the top players in the world at the moment, has won on that big stage in the UK Open. So we'll certainly enjoy the moment, but as we say, short distance in terms of relative terms of TV events, first to six.
Wonder whether he might yet be tempted out by the odd invite here and there. You never know.
83.
Well, I suppose you never know, but we'll have to wait and see. I mean, can you imagine if he said, "Yeah, I'm definitely retiring," and then got to the final of the World Championships, for instance?
Well,
I'm not saying it will happen, but it could.
It's not inconceivable. I think you might have a bit of a reassessment then.
Oh,
Needs another.
83.
But not that one.
Now we're going to have a break straight back. Six darts at 161.
Yes, if he doesn't take it out, at least leave something pretty handy. Juggle 19 and leave double 12.
83.
A bit of a slip there because he's still got some work to do on 78.
So 190, Peter Wright. Pressure to be applied on that 78. Not with darts like that one or that.
Let me just 78. Big finishes like he has done with the 147 and 121. He's had a pretty disappointing leg.
Oh, hello. Has his dart fallen apart?
I think the darts, the points come out the barrel. There we go.
Anybody got any pliers? That'll test your grip.
Well, it's not often you see that, is it? Well, I think he should just leave it in for his next throw.
Ref's giving it a go. Well, I don't... Have you seen that before, Alan?
Well, strangely enough, it's happened to me in the final in Belgium. And the funny thing about it was it put Peter Manley off, so I left it in. Look at that. Well, can you imagine if one of the darts goes in that hole now?
Well, there's almost an argument for changing the board, isn't there?
Well, it makes you wonder that what's going to happen with the next time he throws the same dart.
We will see. We will see. 78 required. Good dart, double 12. After all the distractions, this is a big dart.
54.
No, sir. And you see the reaction.
112.
Facial expressions that spoke volumes.
Yes, I'm going to hit the treble 18 there. I thought, well, fair play to he's holding himself together after that break, but this could spell disaster if Peter Wright can take out double 16, but he hasn't.
What's
your points, Peter?
Double 12 then. James Wilson to narrow the gap again. This is for a break of throw. Double 6.
Can't find it. But he does with the last one. The blink of the eye from James there.
It's James to throw first.
So important. 4-3 and 5-2. Totally different game now.
Game on again. Wright's average has plummeted to 103.
What are we maybe talking about in years to come? Point gate.
Well, like you say that's happened to you. I've certainly, I can't recall seeing that before.
I'm not sure if I've seen it on TV.
120.
It's unusual because you don't often get it, but I suppose it's... he's taking him out very slowly, isn't he? Would have been a strange one if he didn't realise the point had come out and he threw the dart at the board. Then bombs would have made a hell of a noise.
Uh, 81.
Just gone off the boil a little bit here, Peter. And fair play to James Wilson. He's hung in there.
Well, he hasn't played badly all the way through, has he? He's scored pretty well. He's missed a couple of opportunities, yes. Both players have. But over the distance in the eighth leg now, both of them have played pretty well.
97.
On the scoring, certainly.
Now, we're going to have the bullseye here, possibly. Treble 20 now. Tops for 125.
85.
Got a bit excited with that one.
Yes, that was over, James. That was over the crossbar.
Still rising when it hit the board.
Treble 18 for the last one here to leave a straight 98. Turn if he doesn't hit the treble.
40.
Look at him taking his points out really slowly. So it may be affecting him as well because he's got to concentrate and think of that as every time he's going to the board.
If he wins, I think we might see a change of darts tomorrow.
No.
Double 10. Double
what
5.
What makes you think that?
30.
How dare you?
PG Maguire, 100.
Well, James, has he let him off the hook here? Treble 19 would leave double 19. Just lost concentration, hasn't he?
Well, it could be because of that. I mean, at that time, we was thinking it was James Wilson that was going to lose his concentration, which seemed to be when he missed two darts at the double, but...
He's going
to
double four, I think, here, Alan. Double four.
On that left.
Six.
Just inside. He knows the meaning 56. Of missing that double four.
Could be a big miss, that one. That could be a big moment in the match. Tops. This is for the break of throw and 5-3. Yes, and there it is.
Peter.
Well,
right leg is Peter to throw first.
Massive opportunity missed from James Wilson. We said not 5 minutes ago that he hasn't made really any mistakes. He's missed a couple of darts, yes. But that has to be considered as a big mistake.
One more leg then for Peter Wright. But he can't find the treble with the first visit.
You have to remember, in these short distance matches, John, the game can turn around so quickly. If you win a game, a leg against the throw, then you win your throw.
Yeah.
It just changes so quickly in a short distance match.
'64.
A long evening, but spirits still high.
Yes. 78.
Couldn't put it better myself, John. I absolutely love it here in Minehead. They're here for the whole weekend. Some come Thursday nights now. Generally for the Friday, 58. Saturday and Sunday.
A few chants of Yorkshire a little while ago. Must be Wednesday fans if they've come from Sheffield, because they certainly wouldn't be Sheffield United fans.
80.
Yes, we've big got game that face-off on Sunday, haven't we? Me and you, John. United against United. We may have to have a referee in here.
Good dart. 81. There's the referee.
Yeah, well, ask Kirk if you'll stand in the middle.
A former countdown champion.
Yes. Started on the markers scheme on the Pro Tour, as many of our wonderful markers do.
The right throw is under pressure here.
Another one will leave a ton, though. Really, realistically, needed another treble there to leave a ton. 140 is a big finish, still doable, obviously.
Well, can he do it then? Treble 20, treble 20, double 10. Or he could go tops, tops. Well, he's missed the treble 20, so it's all academic. James Wilson, 54, for a break of throw to keep the match alive.
Yes, and when you've missed quite a few darts of the double in a recent leg, and again, that point was stuck in the board. It just stopped the momentum for James Wilson. He had to stand back for a second there. Just adds to the pressure.
Double 18. Yeah. And he's got the break.
Yeah, handled that well, didn't he?
Back in it. Yeah, you could see he had to check himself. He was ready to throw. And Peter apologetically eventually managed to get the dart out of the board. So, are we going to go to the deciding leg once more?
What James Wilson will be hoping. I suppose when something like that happens, John, you maybe think it puts the opponent off, but it's probably affecting both players at points. At points. That was a pun unintended.
Great start. Only needs the one more leg.
Oh, slip there. See the anger there from James Wilson, but recovered slightly.
But he's got the throw now, Peter Wright.
Yeah, good maximum with the first three.
The nine now disappears.
60.
Could leave his point in the board and play his joker. He's just about back in the leg. Next couple of visits could be crucial.
Peter Wright is looking to fill it up, but another treble would be good. Can't find it.
161 is doable, as we know. If James Wilson can stick in something here, I feel like he's got a good fighting chance of the leg.
Is
it finished? But again,
this is
a bigger one.
This is for the match then. 161. Treble 20, first port of call, but not there.
I'm going for bull here. Yeah, good thinking there, because
it
leaves a two-dart finish. If you'd have gone for 19s or 15s to try and hit the treble to leave a double and hit the single, it would have left possibly only one dart at the double.
So this could well be the moment. Peter Wright looking to finish the match right here now with 56. Oh, he's got an 8. 16 for double 16, but he goes tops.
16.
Oh, that was loose.
Yeah, just a lack of concentration there from Peter. He went for 16 tops, hit the 8. Chance for Wilson. Gets the treble. Tops for 5 apiece. Oh, good finish there from the Jammy Dodger.
We're going to have another big upset here.
Game on.
And certainly a talking point, the collapse of Peter Wright's darts, and with it, to an extent, his game. Since that happened, he's not been scoring anything like as freely as previously.
Yeah, it's not been bad, but it's just been at points both players have just suffered a little bit with what's been happening, because it does affect your concentration more than anything, because you're trying to get your rhythm into the game, all of a sudden that stops, so your concentration goes, you can lose the line of what you were throwing at.
100.
That was James Wilson's manager, who we saw briefly a moment or two ago, getting very excited about the possibility of this big upset.
Yes, he won't be happy with
being camera shy.
Darryl getting beat. Make amends if James Wilson can get through here.
100.
Well, still advantage right just about, but it's going to be who keeps the nerve from here.
Yes, they're both just flying in the steady tons.
Can he find a big score, dear? Two treble 20s would help. That'll do nicely.
Well, after the first dart, he'll be over the moon with the second and third dart there. James is hanging in there just in case. Leaves 64. Well, the match up for grabs here, John.
Who's going to blink? 80 needed. 20 the target. He's got it for double 10. Double 5.
75.
Oh dear, and he has never lost to James Wilson. Will he lose now?
Well, when that treble 20 went in, James Wilson must have thought it was all over. But he returns to the board on 64 for a marvellous win.
16 for double 16. Tops though. And he's done it! He's done it! And look what it means! And James Wilson, for the first time up on that stage in this wonderful arena here in Minehead, has put out Peter Wright in a massive upset. Wright was throwing brilliantly until that problem with his darts, but ultimately James Wilson hung in there. He kept on grafting, kept on believing, and in the end gets a great win and takes it by 6 legs to 5.
Game on!